This video covers how to use a timer. So to begin with, you would initialize your timer, and I cover that in a different video, and then you would start your timer. And it would seem pretty obvious that sometime later, you'd also want to stop the timer. But not necessarily. We often use a while one loop in our code, right? And of course, if we're going to be starting and stopping our timer all the time, that's pretty inefficient. The fact is, you could start the timer once, and then never stop it. So if you're going to be using the timer inside a while one loop, it makes sense to initialize it and start it outside the while one loop, and then once your code goes into the while one loop, there's no need to ever stop the timer, because you'll just keep using it. So how do you use a timer? Well, there's a variety of different ways to do this. One thing to keep in mind, however, is that once you start your timer, it's going to keep running in the background. So that means when you want to use it, it's often important to zero some things before you start. So here's one example. So let's say that your intention is that you're going to run your timer from 0 to 300, and then after that finishes, you do something, which relied on that timing. There's one problem with setting things up like this, and that is that, like I said, the timer keeps running in the background. There's no guarantee it's going to be at 0 when you start trying to use this while loop. So it's important to actually zero the timer right before you begin. So you would set the current value of the timer to 0, and then immediately you would have your while loop, where you would be checking to see whether the timer has gotten bigger than the value that you specified. And when it has, this while loop will fail, and then you'll be able to carry on and do something else. So this is one way to use a timer. One other thing I'll point out is that I said do nothing here, but you don't actually have to do nothing inside this while loop. You could be executing other code. This is the strength of a timer, as opposed to a delay. If you had a delay marking out this much time, you wouldn't be able to do anything else with your chip until it had finished. Whereas if you use a timer, you can be executing other code right here. Now here's another way to use the timer. This is only available to you for timer 0 if you're using it in the 8-bit mode. You can set what's called the period, which is effectively the end point of the timer. So you would set the period. Then, again, you want to zero the timer, and you need to do one more thing, and that is you want to set something called the timer interrupt flag to 0 also. So what this flag is, this timer interrupt flag, is that when the timer runs over its maximum value, or over the period that you just set, this flag gets set to 1. So you can write code that will detect that. However, this is another thing that's affected by the fact that when you start the timer, it just keeps running in the background. The timer flag can be set in the background too, so it's important that you always zero it before you begin also. So again, you'd set your period, which is the final value, you set the initial value of the timer to 0, you clear your flag by setting it to 0, and then you can have a while loop, which waits until that flag goes to 1. In other words, when you hit the end point, the period that you set. So as I said, this is a second way to use a timer. So here's the third way to use a timer. In the case of the 16-bit timer, you don't have any option to set the period, so you cannot set the end point. The maximum value is the end point. But you can still set the beginning point, so that's what I've done here. Instead of setting the initial value to 0, I'm setting it to some other value, and then my timer will start at this value and count up to the maximum. And that's how I'll count off my interval of time. With this one, again, you would want to use the flag to tell you when you've run over the maximum value. So you'd clear your flag as before, and then you can still use this piece of code, a while loop that tests whether the flag has been set yet. So again, just as a quick summary, the first way to use a timer is to set the initial value to 0, and then have a while loop that counts up to a certain number that you specify. The second way to use a timer would be to set the period, if that's an option that's available to you, set the initial point to 0, clear the flag, and then have a while loop that tests whether the flag has been set yet. In other words, whether the timer has gotten to the period value that you set, or to the maximum value for that timer. And then the third way to use a timer would be to set an initial value that is not 0, clear the flag, and let the timer count up to its maximum value, which you would detect by checking whether that flag has been set or not yet.